Hi friends, in the previous video we have seen how to create a custom component. We have seen, right? This is the long process, not long process, this is the actual process. So we have created step by step manually. Now Angular CLI comes with some commands, okay? Angular CLI comes with some commands so that we can create a component using a command, so that all the files and all the things will be generated automatically with that command. I am keeping this server running like this only. I am opening a new command prompt. Now in this command prompt, what I will be trying to do is, here I will be, now what I can do is, for example, here I will try to close this one. Okay, remember that it will be running. Now what I will try to do is, yeah, running it. Now here we can write ng, okay, generate component. Okay, so what this command will do is, generate component will try to create a new component. Okay, now we need to give the component name, just like how we have created the user component, we will try to create users component. Okay, users means it will contain, this component will contain the list of users. Okay, user, list of users will contain. This one we will be trying to create ng generate component, the component name. Now you can also write it in a shortcut form, something like gc. It will be gc, ng gc. Gc means G for generate, C for component. We can also write in a shortcut form like this. Now when I try to press enter, now it will try to create the components with the users. How it will be created is, just like this one, how we have created the users, here we have here it has been created. See, we will be able to see that users folder has been created. In this users folder, you will be able to see four files has been created. What are these four files? First one is CSS file, that is useful for styling purposes. We will see that one. And this is the HTML file, which is the responsible for the template, so HTML format. And this is the TS file, so which will be useful for the, what we can say, the logic thing. And this is a spec.ts file, so this is useful for the testing purposes. So right now we will delete this one. So we will learn more about this one in the coming videos, in the going videos. When we are going to Angular testing, we can learn about the spec.ts. Right now we can ignore that one. Now here you'll be able to see the users component has been created. And here also you can ignore this on init and also constructor thing. So constructor, as you already know, for this class constructor is nothing but the entry thing. So we will learn more about this constructor and ng on init when we are learning about the Angular lifecycle. We will see this one. And here selector has been created, app-users, and the template URL users.component.html, and also the style URL is also has given. Okay, so this is the, what I can say, new component with the name users has been created. And the second step after creating component, where we have to see, the second step is we need to register this component in the app module. Let's see whether it is created in the app module or not. Now if you see here, automatically the Angular CLI command has automatically created this component. Okay, automatically created this component in the app module. So that means, so it has already, so Angular CLI command will do all the necessary steps. Now what I will try to do is, in this users component.html, I will call this app-user. Okay, the component, single user. I can replicate this user also. So remember that components are reusable in the Angular. Okay, these components. So app-user is one component we have created, uses single user. Okay, this component is reusable. You need to remember this. So I have used three components, same component three times I am using. And what I will try to do, I will try to use here, instead of user, I will try to use users. Now what it will do, app component will load this app-users, and in this app-users, what we have in this app-users, if we go to the HTML, we are having app-user three times. So it will show in the app-users three times. So if we will go to the app-user.component and we will convert it into the p tag, so that Now here we have created this one. Now let's try to check the output. If I try to check the output, now here you will be able to see that user component has been created 3 times. If you see inspect element here, you see the inspect element here, you'll be able to see inside this app-users. So if you see inside this app-users, you'll be able to see that 3 com app-user, 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 3 times it has been declared. And also in this app-users, you'll be able to see that user component. Okay. So this is how we can create a component using Angular CLI, and also this is how we can use the component in another component. Okay. If you have any doubts or any suggestions, please post the comments below to this video. And if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.